Hello, this is yet another video on this defective USB cable. So in the first video I showed how this defective USB cable makes that devices that require power will not behave correctly because there is too much power loss in this cable. Second video I showed how to measure the resistance of USB cables using a USB meter, and here we are going to use a multimeter, digital multimeter, to make the measurements, to measure the resistance here in this cable. Now this is quite an old multimeter that I have, think about 35 years old, and if I short the probes you will see the resistance doesn't go exactly to zero. But still it is usable for the measurements. If we deduct the 0.5 of the, well, the total resistance here. So I have my USB cable here with four wires in it and a shield. Four wires, wire 1 and wire 4 for the power. Plus is wire 1, negative minus is wire 4, and then wires 2 and 3 are the data cables, which we are not going to take into consideration here. And then my breakout connectors have arrived. I have two USB 3.2 screw connectors here, 10 connectors, because in USB-C you have extra, sorry, USB 3 you have extra wires, but here we are only going to use wires 1 and 4. And I've already put in some small wires to do the measurements. So I connect my end here. And then here, this micro USB, I don't have a micro USB breakout connector, so I have an adapter here from micro USB to USB-A. Of course, all these connectors are also adding to the resistance that is being measured, but because this wire here has several ohms here, we can neglect the resistance in these extra connectors. So now, if I measure, for example, the two endpoints of wire 1, I have about 3.1 ohms. And if I measure the other wire, wire 4, then about 2.6. And remember, we have to deduct the value we have here, 0.4, 0.5, because this is an old meter and no longer properly calibrated for measuring resistance, and it also doesn't have a button to set the resistance to zero when measuring, when there is a short. So what I'm going to do now is here connect the two wires 1 and 4 together so that I can measure over both wires directly the resistance of both wires. So I'm putting them in a serial connection. So in series, not in parallel, I'm shortcutting here 1 and 4, and then on the other end here I can measure the total resistance of both wires. And I'm going to use crocodile connectors. Of course, we should also test these now. 0.4. Like this. And we have about 5 ohms. And if we deduct the if we subtract the 0.4 of the internal resistance here, then we arrive at 4.6, which is quite comparable to the 4.7 we measured with the USB meter. If I'm not mistaken, it was 4.7. And now, just to compare, here is a USB cable that is not defective electrically. It has a much lower resistance, as you can see. So here the resistance is about 0.4, 0.5, which is acceptable for powering devices. This cable here, its resistance is way too high. You lose too much power over this cable, so there is a voltage drop, and then the devices no longer work properly.